Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Paris. For those of you open up, click on this video, you probably just started your YouTube channel or you wanted to start your channel but you're not sure if it works. I want to use this space and time to share my own experience. From my own experience, my own perspective, YouTube have changed me a lot over the past 5 months. It's like a journey of learning and growing. I didn't really write script for this episode because I really just want to talk about my real feeling. I hope it can provide some value to your journey because my experience is a bit different. I started YouTube channel like 5 years ago, but that time I wasn't ready to talk in front of camera. I don't want to open up myself because one thing is I like personal space and I like my own world. I'm not ready to share this world with everyone, even though I know there might be nobody watching the video. But that period of time, I'm still just wanted to observe. I'm a filmmaker myself, so I wanted to observe other creators' life and get inspired by keep creating contents online. So I started the 30-second film artist, as you can see from the earlier days. And I go to visit studio, artist studio every week, and I talk to them, I get inspired, I post online. I post on YouTube every Wednesday, I remember. And that's the start of my own company that focusing on helping artists promote their content and observing the world through my camera lens. And I left that for 3 years because my goal wasn't to get like tons of subscribers. I was just doing this project as an experiment and see what's gonna happen next. And then it gets me to start my own company. We're making website, we're making projects for clients. And slowly I've been realized like we just love new things. We love learning new skills. We want meeting new people. We want to open up ourselves to different challenges, different possibilities. So that's why we love the concept of art and technology. So before COVID happened, we were in Japan and we were doing, we're working on projects that helping clients make an immersive experience. And to me, like the artist part has never died and is always underneath my passion when I work with clients. But you know, when you work with clients, half of the time you are trying to convince, you're trying to sell. So you have to explain to a lot of people why art works, artistic expression works. So it's you have to constantly feed yourself and inspire yourself to not going too far to just to say certain things in order to sell. So when COVID hits and everybody started to stay home, a lot of our events are canceled. Our plan was canceled because at that time we wanted to bring the augmented reality game from Japan to Canada to let people play, have fun with the magic of art and tech. And then once it hit, I realized I wasn't sad at all. I was just, I'm sad about this, what happened in the world and the people are in danger. That's something that you can't, it's out of my control. Just from my own perspective about my career, I all of a sudden realized what I've done before COVID, going to networking, talk to people, try to convince people, all those things, it's not enough for me as creative director and my own owner of my own company. And then we got Oculus, we start to explore the virtuality world and we start to play with VR, we play with a lot of new gears and had like quite a lot of fun at the beginning of the lockdown. And I realized my world is bigger than what I've been explored outside my own world because I was being so busy trying to get clients and go networking or trying to talk to people, convince them my idea is great. Maybe like a lot of creators out there, I feel like half of our job is to convince, right? One day I'll just all of a sudden feel that I want to talk in front of camera. I want to connect with people on through my world. And then once I start this channel, I just have ideas all the time. I want to talk a lot about a lot of things that we've been talking, because my background is in art, and my business partner, also my husband, he's a web developer. He likes new things. When we talk together, we always have new sparks, new ideas, new perspective, because our brain is so different. The way we think is so different. And we've been having a lot of experience about VR, AR, all the tech, art. So at the beginning of starting the YouTube channel, start this playlist, the FA channel Future Is Now, I got so much in my mind, I want to let it out. So every week I have so much idea, I write down scripts. I was so nervous in front of camera, but I know that there's a channel, a space that I can share my idea. And people start to, as we start to get like subscribers, and you realize, wow, there are people in this world, they want this kind of information, they want to hear what we can provide, the value we can provide. And this gives me, encourage me a lot to keep going. And I have to say, I'm not like fall in love with the process of creating YouTube videos yet, but I was opening myself day by day. So we started this FA channel from like end of September, beginning of October, we start to get into it. After 3 months, at the end of the year, I started to go more events. I was having fun, and we start to create more content. Right after New Year, first month of January is quite slow for business, and then I start to feel anxious about my subscriber numbers. I was being so anxious if that day I don't create any content, and I start to sit back. I start to think, what is the point for me to get stressed and anxious just because of the number? If my goal is to share and have fun, be playful, be experimental about all the things I've learned and all the news. So I realized that reward seems like, if you start a YouTube channel, the reward is the number, but the reward should never be the goal. Because if you're just focusing on that little number, you will start to lose the fun part of creating your own channel. If you ask me a couple months ago, even like 2-3 months after I created this FA channel, and you ask me to share experience like this with you, I would definitely say no, because I was thinking the channel I'm sharing is more about from a professional perspective. But I'm not really creating this channel as a business. I'm not trying to sell anything. And I don't have to sell anything. That's the best part about having a channel right now, especially when you don't have millions of subscribers. There's no company asked me to sell anything. And so I start to realize the freedom of having my own channel is not to look at the reward, the goal of the number, but to really be myself. Now I start to enjoy more the process of creating content, not feeling anxious waking up like, do I have content to share today? Like, do I have to post something today? If I don't post, maybe I won't get a subscriber. Instead, I will be trying to read more and explore more, chat more with my partner, and think about what kind of fun, playful thing we can experiment today, and what kind of new life lessons we're having as digital creator. How can we make a space for attract more like-minded people to learn together, to experience together? So this process has been teaching me a lot. Once I start to not think about too much about the numbers, feel like I start to get more, and then I start to have more comments, and I like to talk with people whoever join our Discord server or people comment on my channel. I love having I like to start having conversation with them. Really let me open up more to this world. So I'm not gonna be like, okay, once I reach 1,000 subscribers, or once I reach 1 million subscribers, I'll stop being YouTuber. I think being YouTuber, this title, it's not really a yes or quit for me. it's more about, as digital creator, I will always learn, maybe until I'm like 80 and then this channel is what I built for sharing my experience. So I don't think there will be an ending day for me to share. Because the biggest lesson I learned from 5 years ago, the biggest lesson I've learned is that I made a mistake of stop posting any content 3 years gap, that we didn't post anything on YouTube. But we're still getting somehow some subscriber to watch our content. So my suggestion for you, whoever wanted to create channel on YouTube, you really should just start it, especially if you think you want to create some kind of value into this world, and then you want to attract like-minded people to what you love, what you're passionate about. I really think people can feel if you're passionate about it or you just won't have the numbers. But once you start to passionately share what you like, maybe at the beginning can be once a week, maybe, or once a month, but after years, when you look back, you see how you saw yourself grow. Maybe for 2 years you post one video per month and you get only 5 subscribers. The 5 subscriber will be the person in this world that listen, share idea with you, and wanted to see you as a creator, as a content creator. I think that's a magical journey you can bring yourself into. So yeah, if you are thinking about being a YouTuber, or you just you may have like 20 subscribers within a year, don't give up. I really don't think you should give up. As long as you have something to share, just click on the record button, just share it, and I think the result will be surprising. Be playful and experimental about everything you learn and enjoy the process. That's it I wanted to say. It's not like how to be successful kind of video. I don't think I'm there yet. But I think the biggest success I have right now is to enjoy the process of being an influencer or YouTube content creator. I hope this is like somehow helpful. I want to hear everything what you guys said. Think after you watch this video. And yeah, that's it for today. If you can subscribe our channel, you'll be a huge support for me, because one more subscriber means that there's one more person in this world are enjoying the value I create. I really hope to create more fun and real valuable content on this channel, and hope you enjoy it. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.